As restrictions kept us home, ordering in via food delivery apps quickly became a popular alternative to cooking. But now we can show you the dangerous journey your food is taking between pickup at the restaurant and when it arrives at your dinner table.
When it's bicycle versus truck at 80 kilometres an hour, leaving just centimetres to spare is too close for comfort.
I hold my breath when I see these incidents, always hoping that they're not going to end in tragedy.
This food delivery rider pedals into the WestConnex tunnel at Haberfield, dodging cars he's clearly lost, but makes it out alive at Concord, still confused, a problem with a simple solution.
Their GPS, if they don't tick bicycle on the map, then it won't take them on the bicycle route.
It appears an increasing number of delivery riders are failing to find that button as more hit the road amid an uptick in demand for delivery during coronavirus lockdown. Despite being conscious of COVID safety, this Hungry Panda delivery rider is showing little fear of the deadly situation he's in. Motorway controllers end up putting his bike on the truck and bundling him into the front seat. Wherever he was going, dinner is going to be late. There are signs at every entrance telling cyclists and pedestrians not to enter the tunnel, but already this year there have been 15 breaches of that rule. That's already more than the 12 incidents seen in the past 6 months of last year. This month alone, there were 6 incidents in 12 days. Those caught can cop a fine of $76 for walking and $268 for riding into the tunnel.
It's illegal for a reason. It's very dangerous.
Liz Daniels, Nine News.